one, okay. If this year Malaysia happened to have a white Christmas, how would you celebrate it? If this year Malaysia happened to have a white Christmas, how do you celebrate it?
If Malaysia had white Christmas, definitely it's great time and joy, because I can do my angel on the snow, my little angel, then I can play snowball with my kids. But is it possible to have white Christmas in Malaysia with the hot summer, the hot sun around? If really we have snow in Malaysia, then definitely there's something wrong with the sun already, right? So we have to prevent. But Christmas anyhow is a magical moment. You can dream of white Christmas, you can draw a white Christmas, but it won't happen here in Malaysia. But we can see through the television, or we can make believe of what is white Christmas. Christmas is a day when we appreciate each other, give the gratitude to the one that we love. So it's whether white Christmas, hot Christmas, it's a joyful among the family, among the friends. And you can have a perfectly great Christmas if all the family is gathered together in harmonious, and you can hear the angel ring the bell and you sing the white Christmas, like, I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. This we can sing along, but we can dream it. We can hope one day we can have white Christmas in London, where you have the money to go there, or you can go to Europe. But Malaysia is always the very warm and welcome Christmas. Thanks. Back to you.
Okay, may I welcome the second volunteer?
Hooray!
I was a snowman, I probably dislike Christmas. The first thing that happened in my previous experiences being a snowman during Christmas time was kids plugging out my eyeball. And what do? With my nose? They stuff cucumbers. Now I prefer rabbit sticks, but cucumbers will do also. The other thing I don't like about being a snowman during Christmas, during this magical time, where the singing of Christmas, kids going around, they kick my butt. And the snow, chunks of snow comes out. And you have a furry, bubbly snowman, and he goes thin overnight. I really dislike the kids. At one time, I had the opportunity, in my magical way, to actually make a curling snowball. Now, if you're not sure what a curling snowball is, don't ask me, because I don't know what a curling snowball is. But it's magical, right? I took it, and as I saw the kid passing by, I took a whack. What I did not realize was his mother took the beating. And that was the end of being a very nice snowman experience. You know why? The following night, they all gathered around me and lawn mowed me down all the way. And the snowman did not exist for that Christmas. Back to you.
Number 3 to 5?
3.
Okay. If you can set a new signature dish for Christmas, what will it be and why?
Signature dish.
Okay. If you can set a signature dish for Christmas, what will it be and why?
Signature dish? You mean I cook? Oh my god. If that day ever happens, I think hell will have freeze over and every one of you will probably not here. But imagine that if I can really cook and if I really were to cook a signature dish, I will make it so different that you'll never ever taste it before. It will be maybe what normally when you go for a Chinese restaurant, you've got this 4 seasons. This will be probably 10 seasons. Different flavor, different taste, different aroma, different smell, different look, and different feel. All that. So imagine, just follow me in my thoughts. Imagine the first dish will be sweet as you can possibly think of, as sweet as honey. Second dish could be as salty as you can possibly imagine. That will be probably what the Filipinos will enjoy because they love salty things. Third one, as spicy as you can possibly imagine. Spicier than tom yum. The fourth could be as aromatic, like durian, something aromatic as durian. Pungent with whatever you can imagine. Fifth could be probably as sourish as possible. Anything that you can imagine. Sixth could be as aromatic as fragrance, sweet smelling, smell, flowers. Seventh.
Bitter
as possible, as pedagogue. It could be as tasteless as possible. 9, I'm not sure what, and 10, you just imagine with your eyes. And that is what I would say. How the dish gonna look like, how's it gonna taste like, I have no idea. Back to you.
Number 4 and 5, not much left.
Number 4.
Okay, easy one.
Mm.
If your father is a Santa Claus, what are you going to do in Christmas? If your father is a Santa Claus, what are you going to do in Christmas?
Christmas! It's one of the most fabulous festive seasons in the year. So fabulous that we have Santa Claus, imaginary Santa Claus, for the kids to imagine that they will be getting gifts from the Santa Claus, not knowing that the next morning is they got the gift from their own parents. Now, if my dad is the Santa Claus, great! First of all, I'll be a little bit selfish. I will probably ask my dad to get me a house from our new project and also from our Serene residence, one of the condos. That is for myself. Secondly, a more noble way of mine, kids, I still thought of the kids who have longed to get a Christmas gift from the Santa Claus. I guess Sharon will be hoping so as well. Now, if my dad is a Santa Claus, I want to dress him differently to make him a little bit different from the original Santa Claus and bring him all over Malaysia to distribute gifts. Now, before that, I will definitely survey first what the kids really want. Kids nowadays, no more candy. Perhaps they do not like a lot of candy. Secondly, perhaps they do not like soft toys. They prefer more sophisticated toys, maybe iPhone, iPad. Since my dad is a Santa Claus, and then I can fulfill all their wish lists. Right, Anna?
Yes.
Yes. Anna perhaps want to have...
iPhone.
Anna is not a kid anymore, only for kids.
I boyfriend.
Yeah. So for the kids, whatever they want, I will try my very best to get my Santa Claus dad to fulfill all their wish. Isn't that good? Isn't that nice?
Yeah.
Yes. So let's have a fabulous Christmas season, and back to you.
Should be an angel.
Right.
You all just want to have a try?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, since you have the last question, but I promise an easy one.
Okay.
Yeah. If you have a chance to give Santa Claus a present, what will it be and why? If you have a chance to give Santa Claus a present, what would it be and why?
Okay. If I were to give Santa Claus a present, actually what most of you don't know is Santa Claus is actually my dad. And I would give him I would give him a holiday during Christmas because he's the only one that is working on that day in the entire world. You know, people don't realize it's only the one day when he squeezes down chimneys. He's a very large man, you know. But the rest of the year, he's actually making toys. And it's not an easy job. People think there's like 1,000 elves inside his factory, but actually he does it all himself. You know, every day he doesn't sleep. He sleeps like 5 minutes a day. He eats like 19 times a day, but he only sleeps for 5 minutes. So he works very hard throughout the year, and you know, he gave a lot of his effort to so that I can go to university, so that I don't need to become Santa Claus when I grow up. So, you know, that's probably the best present I could think of to get him. Other than that, maybe I'd get him a new car. You know, he's been using the same sled with Rudolph and the other reindeers for so many years already. You know, it's time for an upgrade, time of technology. He doesn't really need reindeers. Maybe I'll get him one horse instead of, you know, 8 reindeers, which is just about as powerful. I get him a new suit. You know, it's always red, which, you know, in Chinese is very lucky, but, you know, he's been Santa Claus for many years. He's quite a lucky guy already. You know, he doesn't need a red suit. So it'd probably be something along those lines, you know, holiday, car. And, you know, he lives in the North Pole. When I say holiday, I mean like Bali. you can lie on the beach, relax, and, you know, have a margarita or two instead of, you know, eggnog. You know, that's the only thing they serve. So, you know, he'd be resting on the beach in Bali, just thinking of what to do. And, you know, I don't want to do that anymore. So that's what I'd give him. I'd give him a break.
William, you are fabulous.
Yeah.
Okay, now I'll pass back my time to our Toastmaster of the evening, Riza.
Yeah.
Thank you.